very, very special day for us. There are two projects that we will be celebrating and inaugurating that have been many years in the works. One of them, the Fairfield Loop Trail, which is a 16-mile walking and biking trail around the perimeter of Fairfield, connecting all of our best parks, the county park, going through native wetlands, prairie, connecting neighborhoods. It's really a tremendous achievement of about 14 years from its visual conception to building it all out. There's about $6 to $7 million invested. So we will be celebrating and opening that today. And where we will actually conduct that ceremony will be at a place where we are celebrating our history again. And that is the place where there are barns that were owned by the Mazdan family, who raised champion Perchon horses in the 1850s, 1860s time. And these barns have been restored. We also have converted one of our old homes into a welcome center. So this area will become very strategic for us as a trailhead for this 16-mile loop trail, and also a welcome center to our whole community. I know I'm probably forgetting a few other things, but again, we are very, very fortunate to have celebrating both what you're doing here this weekend and all of these other activities. I hope you have the time to enjoy some of those while you're here. I also want to say that Dave Neff, who is my good friend and have been introduced to John Braidwood and John Blackstock over the last 7 or 8 years, and of course Dr. Tree, who is a very venerable citizen of our community, do a wonderful, wonderful job of continuing the presence of Parsons here in Fairfield. It's very, very important to us, and I know you appreciate it, but I would like you to extend a thank you and a congratulations to everything that they do on behalf of Parsons College. With that, again, I would just like to say congratulations to the inductees and the honorees, and enjoy your time in Fairfield. Thank you.
Now the moment you've been waiting for. Anticipation. This is the third annual induction of the Parsons College Wall of Honor. Our procedure will be, we will call the presenter to the podium, and after brief remarks, our honoree will be called to the stage to be presented with their own personal Wall of Honor plaque by Dr. Robert Tree. We'll then go to the middle of the stage for a photograph that John Blackstock will take, and then the honoree will remain in the chairs, and we will fill all 10 chairs with those honorees or their designee. So that will be our procedure, and we'll move forward from there. Our first inductee, Doug Billings, class of 63, Holiday Inn executive. Dr. Michael Gilton, please come to the podium as the presenter.
Good morning. First of all, congratulations to this entire class of inductees. It's like a who's who in America. The qualifications to be nominated and being an inductee are basically twofold. One, a very successful career, and two, a love of Parsons College. And I'm pleased to have introduced and to have nominated Doug Billings, who certainly fills both of those criteria. Doug graduated from Red Oak, Iowa in 1959. He had an outstanding high school career in many plays, physical activities, things, athletics. He was class president, and he was awarded the American Legion Award from Red Oak. He visited Parsons that spring, and there he met Dr. Roberts, and they had a good relationship throughout his time here at Parsons, which was 4 years to get his degree in political science and history. And then also, Doug did many things while he was at Parsons. For one thing, he was vice president and president of SIGEPS. But probably more importantly, for a period of almost 2 years, he was president of the Unifraternity IFC Council. And during his tenure, as Parsons was expanding, three new fraternities were introduced to the Parsons campus and a couple of sororities. He came to Parsons on a Presbyterian scholarship, where he majored in political science and history. Parsons, he also had an outstanding career otherwise, and was recognized. He was among Sam Green's Key, several business, a retail clothing business, and he was there for a few years, and in Red Oak, it was the smallest town in America to have a Holiday Inn, and the inn was failing. And his business associate recommended him to take over management of the inn. Well, 7 years later, he was given stock options and so forth, and had a controlling interest in it, and his standards of excellence and hospitality led that inn to thrive. And so he sort of got involved in more things. Things snowballed. In 1986, he was president of the Hotel and Hospitality Development Company that he started. In 84, he was, if I can read this right, hospitality executive of Holiday Inn International Corporation. And things just went on from there. Now, they told me I had 3 minutes, and they knew, I guess, that I'm a college professor and would ramble on and on. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to tell you that things just snowball from here. And he's had an amazing, successful career. Now, he's been involved in recent years with the SIGEP reunions. And in 2008, he hosted the reunion. And part of that was we were invited to his house for, you know, crackers and snacks and such like that. And in his living room, the entire living room table was filled with memorabilia from Parsons College. There was the program for when we graduated. We both graduated in 63. There was the O.B. Nelson book. There were many, many, many other things. I mean, here's a man who loves Parsons College. You cut his finger, it'll lean Kelly Green. Now, he and his wife, Annette, have also been very active as just citizens. They're very active in their church, the Episcopalian church in their community. She's president of the women's group. They both serve as ulcers, and he's on the vestry board. They have 2 daughters, and they're very involved with their church for charities. So there you have it. It's as brief as I can put it for a career that's outstanding. There are more details in this program. But you have a model citizen who loves Parsons, who's had an outstanding career, and it was very easy to nominate Doug Billings for this honor.
Coastal Carolina University has grown from 3,000 students in 1995 to almost 10,000 students today. And we have adopted Coastal Carolina as our new university. We are great friends with President Dr. David DeCenzo and his wife Terry, and we're doing things there that we would be doing here at Parsons if Parsons was still alive and active today. But let me guarantee you that Parsons College, as long as you and I keep it in our hearts and minds, will always be here and will always be alive. And so I appreciate very much what all of you folks here at Fairfield and throughout the country continue to do to make Parsons College a living memory and something that's real in the hearts of all the people that it was touched by. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, many days we are thankful when we get up in the morning, the sun comes up, and today I would like to say that Gobble is in the house. He just arrived. Dr. John Gladfeld, a 1948 ophthalmologist. Would Robert Gladfeld please come to the podium as presenter? And as he's coming forward, I'd like to make a special note that John Gladfeld's wife, Bonnie, is deceased, but she is being honored this weekend at the museum where you can go this afternoon. Her lifelong interest in collecting paper dolls is being celebrated with an exhibit at the Carnegie Historical Museum. Examples of her Tilly Matilda collection are on display, also a dress that she was inspired by Claudette Colbert, paper doll, sewing machine, which has been given to her by Johnny Carson's mother, is also in the exhibit. You can enjoy these artifacts when you visit the Parsons display this afternoon. Robert.
Thank you all. It's actually an honor to be here. We've had a number of the family members over time that have attended Parsons, besides Dad.
My mother went to Parsons. That's actually where Dad met her. Some of his cousins went. His mom, my grandmother, Susan Gladfeld, actually graduated with a two-year teacher certificate from Parsons at the same time that Dad graduated. So it's rather interesting, a mother-son graduation at Parsons. Dad was born here in out near Batavia, Libertyville area. Grew up on a farm. When we used to visit the farm as little kids, it was rather interesting since Dad was on the public health service then. So we kind of lived in Staten Island, New York, or Norfolk, Virginia, or places like that. But we always visited the farm, and it was a very different experience, meeting and knowing people from Iowa. It's where we learned that there was things such as cash money. People who had small farms, it was very important to actually have cash money. And then Grandma had her egg money. So it's a very down-to-earth type society. Anyway, Dad attended several of the one-room schoolhouses out in Batavia, actually on the farm. Is one of the one-room schoolhouses that he attended. He's, along with George Davis, has had the place restored. Anybody ever interested in going out there, let us know. When he made it to Parsons, he basically was the overalls, you know, the bib overall, you know, type kid, had one pair of shoes. He was very fortunate the university took an interest in him. They gave him positions for setting up labs and cleaning the rooms and whatever that basically covered his tuition. The school managed to loan him books. So he was able to attend Parsons. That was probably the only reason. He also managed to graduate from Parsons in 3 years, which was quite an accomplishment. He decided to head off to medical school. He applied at the University of Louisville, was rejected because he was too young. He went up to the University of Iowa for a year,